So basically, there will find three kind of algebraic structure. There are many other subkinds, but commonly, we say the three kind of structures are there. One is group, another is ring, and fields. Okay, so what are those group, rings, and fields? We will discuss. Let's see. First comes group. So a group is set of symbols with a law defined on it. Okay, so that means in a group there will be a set of symbols. Those symbols can be some alphabets, it can be some digits or anything. Okay, so every symbol has an inverse which is called 1/x, and a group has identity symbol 1. So you know what is inverse symbol? Inverse means if you have 1, inverse of 1 will be 1/1, or if you have a number of 5, inverse of 5 is 1/5, and we know that a number multiplied by its inverse will give you identity symbol, that is 1. So if there is a inverse available for a symbol, it must have a identity symbol as well in the group. So you can understand that they are more formally, a group can be defined in two tuple, G and G denoted for group and asterisk, satisfied the following axioms. First is the closure or asterisk, which gives, you can see, G product G to G. That means using asterisk, whatever number or operation you will do over the symbols in G, that resultant symbol should also belong into the same set G. Say like you have numeric set 1 to 9, okay, and you are doing 1 plus 2 equal to 3, so 3 should also be into G. So as in the set G you have 1 2 3 4 up to 9, so 3 belongs to that. But if you do 8 plus 9, then this set is not going to satisfy your operation. Okay, so you have to understand that what operations are there which are acceptable are supported by the group. So as you have seen that for a set or for a group, I should not call it group, for a set with decimal numbers, you can't say it is bound under addition. Because if you add two numbers, you can't guarantee that this finite set will give you a result which belongs to the same set G. Okay, but if you think about a set G which is having all possible decimal numbers, in that case you can say yes, G plus or any number plus any other number, and whatever the result you will get, that will belongs to G, right? So it depends whether G is infinite or G is finite. Okay, then associativity, that means say this star is representing some operation, then if you do A star B star C, then it should be support associativity rule, like you can do B star C first, then the star is representing some operation, okay, and with the result you can do A stack B. Okay, for any A, B, C belongs to G. Okay, then identity, there exists an element E in G such that for all A belongs to G, A multiply E equal to E multiply A equal to A. That means if you multiply the identity element with any of the member of G, it should return you, the result should be the same number. Okay, so that means multiplying with the identity should not change the number. Okay, then inverse, so for a symbol A belongs to G, there exists a unique A dash. A dash means 1/A. Okay, that is inverse, such that A multiply A dash equal to A dash multiply A, that means it is also showing the associativity rule, equal to the identity symbol E. Okay, so these are the things their properties group a group follows. Okay. Then there is a cyclic group. So what is cyclic group? If all the elements in the group can be represented by a particular symbol, like say you have a group which is having a square, a cube, f to the power 4, and so on, then you can say all the elements in the group can be represented by a. Okay. And let the identity be, or the identity will become e equal to, e is the identity symbol for that group, cyclic group, then e should be equal to a to the power 0. Okay. And you know, anything to the power 0 equal to 1. Okay. So a example is cyclic, a group is cyclic if every element is a power of some fixed element. Okay, so that is what I have told you, that if b equal to a to the power k for some a, and every b in group, that means for any value of k you are putting here, and a to the power k you have, and whatever result you will get, that is b, right? So whatever value of b will get using this relation b equal to a to the power k, and if all the b's belongs to a group, then you will say that as b is the set of all the b's, b values are forming a cyclic group. Okay, so a is said to be generator of the group. Okay. Because all the symbols or all the values in the groups are generated using a only. Then comes ring. A ring is set of symbols with two laws. Okay, so in group, you know, these laws are not defined, so these laws are given by this asterisk, that and that asterisk can represent anything. So based on the situation, it can be, you know, multiplication, it can be division, it can be anything else. Okay, but here when you are speaking about ring is having only two laws, that is addition and multiplication. So you can understand in the a ring is shown inside a group. That means in the group, which are the symbols, or which subset of the symbol of a group satisfying only these two rules, addition and multiplication, those subset of a group can be called as a ring. Okay. So it does not need to have an identity. Okay, so a ring may not have an identity, that is no mandatory thing, and not every symbol has an inverse, and in a ring all the symbol may not have an inverse also. Okay, now a ring R, so three tuples it is given, R addition and multiplication satisfy the following axioms. R plus is associative group, and associativity, you know how we show, that is A into B into C equal to A into in bracket B into C for all ABC in R. Okay, and distributivity axioms, that is A plus B into C, if you have, then A into C plus B into C, you can just distribute C over the A plus B. Okay, so if these two things satisfied, then you can say yes, and yes, this is a ring. Okay, then comes field. So a field is set of symbols with two laws, again like ring, plus and multiplication defined on it, such that each law forms a group. Okay, so each, you can see in the ring, it was saying that each of the law may not form a group, because it is saying that it may not have identity, it may not have inverse. But in case of field, we are saying that each of the law forms a group. That means this addition and multiplication, when you will apply, they should they should satisfy the property of a group also. Okay. Then it is a field is given by F, addition and multiplication satisfy the following axioms. F multiplication is a commutative ring. So then identity, there exists a multiplicative identity 1 in F such that A into 1 equal to 1 into A equal to A for all A belongs to F. So this is simply identity rule, you can understand, the very basic. Then the inverse, for any A belongs to F minus, you know, the set excluding 0 into it, because, you know, you can't have inverse of a 0, right? So there exists a unique multiplicative inverse 1 by A such that A into 1 by A equal to 1 by A into A equal to 1. So this expression is very simple, you can understand, right? So this is what is about field. So field, you can say that it is having basically two rules. One is addition, another is multiplication, and both of them should form a ring. Okay. So individually they should be ring, and they should have identity element as well and inverse element as well. Okay. So here is the big picture. First comes the group. Group is having this four rules. This is closure under addition, associativity of addition, additive identity, and additive inverse. So a group must have these four things. So we have already seen this, right? Then comes abelian group. So it comes with one more property, that is commutativity of addition. Okay. Then comes ring. It comes with three more property with the existing properties of the group, which are closure under multiplication, associativity of multiplication, and distributive laws. Okay. Then comes commutative rings. This is commutativity of multiplication and this is the only thing comes with ring. If you have this property also, that is commutativity of multiplication, then it becomes a commutative ring. Then comes integral domain. It comes with two more property, multiplicative identity and no zero divisor. That is integral domain. And with that, if we add another property, multiplicative inverse, then it becomes a field. Okay. So here you can see the field is the most strict among all of them. It is having the smallest set, and group is the biggest one. So you can see the maximum flexibility you have in the group. Then there is some group out of the normal groups are called abelian group. Then comes rings, then commutative rings, then integer domain, and then field. So you can understand that how these properties are distributed among them, are satisfied by those different kind of structures. So next we will see modular arithmetic. So it was a bright cold day in April and close to 13. So in this was proposed by George Orwell in 1984. Okay. So what is modular arithmetic? First, you can understand this very easily using a clock. So a clock is basically having 12, you can say, dots or 12 intervals. Okay. So 1 hour, 1 hour, like this, so 12 hours it can show on a, you can say, circle. Okay. So if right now it is the time, the time is 10 o'clock, what will be the time after 4 hours? So immediately we say that it will be 2 o'clock. But thing is that why 2 o'clock? Why you are saying 2 o'clock? Why not you are saying it's for 14 hours? Okay. Because immediately in our mind, what happened? We have done a modular arithmetic. That means we have added 4 to 10, we got 14. Then we, as there is only 12 part intervals, so we have subtracted 12 from 14 and we got 2. And we said that it is 2 o'clock. So this is nothing but modular arithmetic, what happened in our mind. Okay. So there is division also, you know, and division is quite clean and tidy using modular arithmetic. Like if you are doing 32 divide 4, you can get simply 8. Okay, so this is the simple division, right? Now if you look at the next, if you are dividing 32 by 5, then what will happen? You can have 6 different division. So you know, out of 32 squares, you will cover 30 square, and we will have 2 square left, which can be divided by 5. So it this division is having a remainder of 2. Okay, so we got a remainder 2. So the remain, so this remainder is known as modulus in modular arithmetic. Now there is a little bit difference between remainder versus remainder and modulus. Bit tricky, not all the time it is necessary to know, but for information. So in Python, if you calculate modulus, if you try to calculate, okay, so what you write the, in the code, so -27, 13. So there is a negative number. Basically, this difference appears most of the time when you have a negative number here. You are dividing something with negative number. You are having a negative number and dividing with some number. Okay. So if you, in Python, if you do that, what result you will get? You will get 12. Okay. So there is no issue. It is correct result. Okay. But if you see in other language like C sharp, if you do that, -27 mod 13, it will result -1. So what it have done, it initially just overlooked the negative sign, and 13 into 2, 26, so 26 minus, 27 minus 26 equal to -1 it had done. Okay, so this is called a remainder. If you do a simple division and get the remainder, then it is true, it is correct, right? But if you are targeting to get a remainder, if you are targeting to get the modulus, then this Python is correct. Okay, so some fix you can do to kind of convert this remainder to modulus. So what you can do, you can simply add this remainder with the divisor, that is 13. So if you do that and get again mod of 13, mod of the result, then you will get the correct result. So what will happen? You will get, it is 12, so minus 1 plus 13 equal to 12. So 12 divided by 13, if you do, you will get 12 as a remainder. So if you do it in two steps, then C sharp will also give you the remainder. Okay, sorry, give you the modulus. Okay, but the same operator in Python gives you direct modulus. Okay, then modular arithmetic as a remainder, what we usually know and use, that is, since both 15 and minus 9 leave the same remainder 3, when divided by 12, we say that 15 congruent, equivalent sign, okay. Congruence, yes, 15 congruence minus 9 mod in mod 12. That means, what does this means? That 15 congruence minus 9, when you write, that means that, and in mod 12, that means that if you take 15 mod 12, what result you will get? That is equal to minus 9 mod 12. Okay. So if you do this operation, you can get, on both the side, you will get 3. So congruence, we call this as a congruence number. Okay, so 15 and minus 9 are having same modulus when you are doing mod 12. Okay, so this congruence thing you will find many times in your cryptography paper. Okay, now other ways of doing modular arithmetic. First perform the usual arithmetic and then find the remainder. That is, you can do a simple straightforward thing. For example, find 123 plus 321 mod 11. Then you can simply do, you can add these two number, you will get 444 and divide it by 11 and take the mod. Okay, so you will get 4 as a modulus. So you can also write in form of congruence that in mod 11, 123 plus 321 is a congruence to 4. Okay, so I think this concept is clear. Then a modular arithmetic, some other thing we will see that can do modular arithmetic with any group of integer. Okay, so the size of the set Zn, it doesn't matter. You can have any number of symbols in the set. And for a commutative ring for addition, form a commutative ring for addition with a multiplicative identity. And you can do see also some of the particular particularities, like if a plus b equal to a plus c mod n. Okay, that means when you are doing modulo n operation, if you found somewhere that a plus b equal to a plus c, then you can simply say b equal to c mod n. Okay, but if a dot b equal to a dot c mod n, then b equal to c mod n only if a is relatively prime to n. So this is very important property that when it is instead of addition, when you are having multiplication here, then this thing you can only say that b equal to c in mod n only if this a is a relatively prime to n. Okay, then comes congruence. So that is what I was telling about congruence. So for positive integer n, the integers a and b are congruent mod n if their remainders when divided by n are the same. That understand, that is what I have already told you. Then like if you have 52 and 24, okay, and if you are using modulo 7, that then 52 mod 7 will be equal to 24 mod 7. So you can say 52 and 24 are congruent. Okay, as we can see above, the 52 and 24 are congruent in mod 7 because 52 mod equal to 3 and 24 mod 7 equal to 3. Okay, not that here we are not writing equal sign, we are writing equivalent sign or congruent sign. Okay, now properties of addition in modular arithmetic. If you have a plus b equal to c, then you can do a mod n, b mod n congruent or equivalent to c mod n. Okay, if a equal to b mod n, that means a congruent b mod n, then you can say a plus k congruent to b plus k mod n. So that will happen, okay, for any integer k. Then if a congruent b mod n and c congruent d mod n, then a plus b congruent b plus d mod n. Okay, so this is another property. And another is, if a congruent b mod n, then minus a congruent minus b mod n. Okay, So these are the four properties you need to remember when we will do addition in modular arithmetics. Then multiplication. If A multiplication B equal to C, then A mod N, then B mod N, understand, individually, A mod N, B mod N equal to or congruent to C mod N. Okay, if A congruent B mod N, then if you multiply both the side with K, K multiplied A congruent K multiplied B, you know, and do mod N over it for any integer K. So multiplication with any integer K is acceptable. Okay. Now if A congruent B mod N and C congruent D mod N, then AC, just multiply the left side equal to multiply the right side mod N. Okay, so this is the properties, these are the properties for multiplication. Next is exponentiation. If A congruent B mod N, then A to the power K congruent B to the power K mod N for any positive integer K. Then if division, okay, if GCD of K comma N equal to 1, then you can say that K A congruent K B mod N, okay. Then A congruent B mod N, okay. So if K multiplication A congruent K multiplication B mod N, if this is going to satisfy, then it will also satisfy A congruent B in mod N, okay. Then multiplicative inverse. If A and N are integers such that GCD of A and N give you 1, then there exist an integer AX such that AX equal to or AX congruent 1 mod N. So this is very important in RSA, you will find this. Okay. So it will satisfy only when, that means multiplication of two integer AX congruent 1 in mod N, this will only satisfy if GCD of A and N is 1. Okay, then X is called the multiplicative inverse of A modulo N. Okay, so X here is going to be the multiplicative inverse of A modulo N, definitely. Okay, now if you look at this image, there is 7 glasses, all are in golden color, but it is said that there is one glass which is made of real gold. Okay, so and if it is said that you start counting and when in a circular way, and when you will finish counting 1000, where you will stop, that is the golden glass. Okay, so now how we will find that which glass is of gold, made of gold? So many of you may start counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, like this. But a smart one of you will do what? Will just mod 1000 with 7. Okay? So whatever result you will get, you will say that is the golden glass. Okay, so you can get the result very fast. So then we are going to discuss about Galois field. So Galois field also you may have heard about many times. So one person called Galois. Okay. So who had came up with the idea of Galois field? And unfortunately, that mathematical genius was shot dead in a duel at the age of 20. So you can understand that. Who have given this Galois field concept actually had died at the age of 20. Okay, so Gallusfield is the name. It is named after Everest Gallus, also known as finite field. Finite fields play a key role in cryptography. Computer data are represented using 0 and 1, which are the components in Gallus field, whose number of elements is 2. So in the Gallus field, the number of element is 2 in case of binary representation of data. So finite field properties, there are a few properties. Okay, first is it is closed. Any operation performed with element from the set returns an element contained in the original set. So that we already know. Then it is associative. If you have A multiplication B multiplication C, is the same as A multiplication in bracket B multiplication C. Then it is having an identity property. That means there exists a natural element, usually 1, such that A, 1 equal to A. That means you got it? A multiplication 1 equal to A. Okay. Then inverse, within the set there is another element such that A inverse equal to A multiplication A inverse equal to 1. The order of operation does not matter, because you can do A multiplication B equal to B, or B multiplication A, anything, it will give you same result. So these are the property of finite field. Okay, now come to the Gallus field. Gallus field denoted by GF, it should be P to the power N actually. It has P to the power N elements, where P is a prime number and N is whatever you choose. Okay, so you can choose N yourself, or user can choose it. In particular of N, use the field like this form, Gallus field of P, that means P element, or Gallus field of 2 to the power N, that means Gallus field with 2 to the power N elements. Okay, so Gallus field 5, if I say P is 5, that can be written as GF5, it can have 5 elements like 0 to 4, which consists of 5 elements, okay, where each of them is a polynomial of degree 0. You can't have a finite field with 12 elements. Why you can't have a 12? Why you can't have a finite field with 12 elements? Because it is not a prime number. Okay, basically when you will have like this GF5 or GS something, it will be 12. It should be prime number. And the other thing that you have in this form 2 to the power n, basically this number should be representable by 2 to the power n form. Okay, so as you can see here, it is already written that if you are having in the form of GFP, we call it a prime field, and if you have something P to the power m, we call it extension field. Okay, now see, look about Gallus field 2 to the power n form. So if you have a Gallus field like this 2 to the power 3, it can have elements like this 0, 1, 2. Okay, 0, 1, 2. That means 2 to the power 0 to the power, 0 to the power 1 and 2 to the power, no. It is just generating the element from 0 to 2. So 0, 1, 2, then 2 plus 1 is going to be the another element. And then 2 plus 2 is going to be another element. Then again, 2 plus 1 and 2 added together and got the other element. Then 2 plus 2. Is going to give you 6. This is another element, and 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1 going to give you 7. That is going to be the other element. So which consists of 2 to the power 3 equal to 8 elements. Okay, which is 0 to 7. Okay, where each of them is a polynomial of degree at most 2, evaluated at 2. Okay, then prime field arithmetic addition. So look at this, you have 3 plus 4 mod 5, it is very simple, 7 it gives you, so 7 mod 5 equal to 2, like this, 5 mod 5 equal to 0, 3 mod 5 equal to 3, so you understand this. Then prime field arithmetic subtraction, so the same rule is applied here for subtraction, 4 minus 0 is 4, so 4 mod 5 is going to give you 4, then 4 minus 2 mod 5 if you do, you will get 2, because and 4 minus 2 is 2, 2 mod 5 is 2. And so on. Okay, then prime period arithmetic multiplication. Again here, you have to first multiply the numbers, then we have to take the mod. Okay, so you can see, look at these examples. Okay, then prime period arithmetic division. So in case of division, you have to look a bit carefully. There you can see here, what it is happening. So first it is multiplying 4 into 4, then it is taking mod 5, we are getting 1. So 0 is, so you have to understand that here in this field, prime field, you have element 0 which does not have inverse. Okay, so if you get this situation like here, 0 multiplication with what will give you 1, that is undefined, does not exist. Okay, so this is what the division things. Okay, so if you write the same set by removing 0 out of